It was a beautiful spring morning in the garden. The sun shone, the birds were singing in the trees. Even Slowcoach seemed to be happy for once.
Good morning, Slowcoach.
Oh, a morning, Weed. And what a good morning it is, too. Lovely and peaceful and quiet. Shouldn't be allowed. Bill and Ben's game took them to the garden shed. Ben had knocked a cotton reel off the workbench, and when Bill came into the garden shed, poor Ben had got quite tangled up. At last, with Bill's help, Ben was free.
Ah, Flobbadob.
Bill had an idea. He thought they'd be able to have some fun with the thread.
Oh dear.
Bill and Ben were feeling rather mischievous as they watched Whimsy spin her web. While Ben waited by the kennel, Bill skipped over near to where Whimsy was working.
Flobbadimsy.
Hello, Bill. You startled me.
Bill pretended he found something really interesting in the watering can.
Flobbadob!
What is it? What have you found, Bill?
It's Flobbadob, an elephant!
An elephant? Oh, don't be silly, Bill. You couldn't get an elephant in there.
Hey, Flobbadong.
It hasn't gone.
A Flobbadob, an elephant? Flobbadelephant!
Wasn't there in the first place. It was just playing tricks on me. Naughty Bill. Ooh, that's funny. My web seems to have sunk. Wait till I tell Weed about this. Oh, dear. An unpruned rose.
Rose was giving her buds a lesson in how to be a beautiful flower, while Bill and Ben made a pretend fly out of their cotton.
In the same bed. Avoid flies like the plague. Be they black fly, green fly,
purple fly.
This is no time for silly remarks from you. Thank you very much.
Flubberdoes.
Oh, Flubberlub.
What? What is it?
A flubberfly.
Ah! It's a fly! Help! Get off! Help! Help!
Flubberfly.
The Flubberdodden.
I suppose you think that was funny.
With poor Rose all of a fluster, Bill and Ben left the garden next door, wondering what mischief to get up to next. It didn't take them long to decide. Slowcoach was reading a very interesting book about lettuce.
I love a good book, especially one about lettuce. Oh, in fact, I can almost smell lettuce right now. Oh, the butterhead lettuce. And, look, hang on a mo. I can smell lettuce. Well. Isn't that kind? Someone has left me a lettuce leaf. Must be a bit windy today. That's funny. Poor old Slowcoach. As fast as he tried to grab the lettuce leaf, the naughty Flowerpot men pulled it out of his reach.
Stand still and be eaten. Come here! Halt!
At the name of the shell.
So it was you, was it?
Whimsy, Slowcoach and Tad were telling Weed about the mischief Bill and Ben had been up to.
If you don't do something about it,
I will.
Bill? Ben, you've been very, very naughty. Well, don't you think you ought to say something?
Oh, flubber-dory, slubber-lub.
Flubber-dory, Whimsy.
Flubber-dory, Ted.
I should think so. And it won't happen again, will it?
Flub.
Flub.
Now, off you go.
Flubber-way!
Look at them again.
Yeah, cheeky bear.
I think I might have an idea. Bill! Ben!
Hello!
How would you like to play a new game?
Flubber up!
Weed explained the game to them. It was called the Keeping Quiet and Still game. First, they had to sit on the ground.
And the one who can keep quietest and stillest wins the game.
Flubber lubber lovely.
Woohoo! Flubble lubble fun!
3, 2, 1, go!
Oh!
Hello there!
Slowcoach was pleased that the game seemed to have brought some peace and quiet to the garden. Peace at last. Whimsy didn't think she'd be getting any more surprises that day either. And Rose was happily giving her buds another talking to.
And must be kept clean and dust-free at all times.
Boring!
I heard that!
The game had been going very well. Neither Bill nor Ben had spoken or moved for a very long time.
Well done, you two! You did really well. But I think it's about time for bed.
Bill and Ben wanted to know who'd won the game.
Well, you were both very good indeed. But I think the winner has to be...
Flubber-dub.
Bill and Ben realised that Weed had played a trick on them. But they couldn't stay cross for long. After all, they'd been playing tricks on the others all morning.
Good night, Bill. Good night, Ben.
And as they settled down in their flower pots, Bill and Ben thought of all the fun they were going to have tomorrow.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben. We'll be right back.
One chilly evening, Bill and Ben had something important to do.
Oh, my God.
Where on earth are you going to at this time of night?
Oh, flubba-dubba-da-loo-loo.
Well, I can't see the new moon.
Now, when you see the new moon, cross your legs and make a wish. In your case, just cross your fingers. The trouble is, it's very cloudy. I don't think we shall see the new moon tonight.
No.
Oh. Good night.
Bill and Ben didn't want to give up, so they were pleased that Gnome had stayed awake to see the new moon. Bill didn't want Ben to frighten the new moon away, so they all settled down to wait for the clouds to blow away. They waited and waited, but still there was no new moon to be seen.
Rubber dude. Rubber dude to bed.
Bill wanted to go to bed.
Flubba-dubba-doodle.
But Ben wanted to stay up as long as Gnome stayed up. Next morning, Ben asked Gnome to nod if he'd seen the new moon.
Flubba-dubba-nod.
Gnome didn't nod, so Ben knew he hadn't seen it. Ben felt rather strange, so he went home for a sleep.
Hello, Ben. Oh, dear. Have you been up all night?
Flubba-den. Hey, whoa. Rubba-dubba-dees. Watch it, Bill. Hello, Ben. Ready for the race?
Rubba-flub.
Oh. It's time for our race to see what's quickest, you know what I mean? Hopping or running. Come on, get in line.
I'll start your race. On your marks, get set, go! Go on, Ben! Go!
Oh, frogs and flowerpot men. Why do they have to rush about? Next time I'll trip them up. Right. Now I'll trip up Ben. Whoa! I wanted to make you fall down.
Bill and Tad had already raced once round the garden.
Ooh, Flubba-dun. Yeah, what's that, Ben? Ooh, wow, what a weird noise. Rubber-dubbers or slubber-lub? Yeah, Slowcoach will know what your problem is.
Yes. Ah, yes. Coughs, sneezes. Just as I thought. Ben is suffering from what we experts call a nasty cold. He must go straight to bed, wrap up warm, swallow medicine, and sip hot lettuce soup.
Okay, have you got some hot lettuce soup?
No, but he can borrow a lettuce leaf.
Here you are, Ben. Have a go at that.
Yes. Hot soup would have been much better.
Oh, poor Ben. Look, he's shivering.
Now you'll soon be cosy and warm, Ben. There, now you'll feel better.
Yep.
Well, it might take a few minutes.
Rubba-blubba-blubba-blubba-blubba-blubba-blubba.
No problem. I'll keep an eye on Ben. You get the medicine. No, Bill. I don't know what medicine is. It's not my job to know what medicine is. It's my job to...
Ooh!
What's the matter, Bill? You look upset.
Ben's got a nasty cold, Pry, and Bill wants to know what medicine is. I've told him that's not my job. My job is to...
Oh, I know what medicine is.
Or Flobbadob?
It's brown stuff. And I've seen humans give brown stuff on a spoon to their children when they've got nasty colds.
Now I can help. My compost brown. Bill, you take some of my brown stuff for Ben.
Bill thanked Wubbs, but he really didn't think it would be right for Ben to swallow compost.
Ooh, brown stuff, eh?
I'm sure I've got some brown stuff. Oh, yes.
The very thing.
Rubber slubber-lub.
Oh, so that's what medicine is.
I've often wondered.
Yes, it's a shame it tastes horrid, Ben, but that probably means it's making you better.
Oh, blubber of a liver.
Yes, he is shivering a lot. You should take him somewhere warm. The greenhouse, perhaps.
But ow, we can't carry him.
You could make a sort of stretcher and drag him along.
Okay, Ben? Okay, Bill? Good luck, Bill.
Ah, Bill, what have we here?
Flubber-dubber-dusty-dole.
Ooh, a nasty cold, eh? Ooh, poor Ben. Well, he needs to rest and keep warm. Oh, my word, Bill, you look tired.
Rubber flub.
Well, you go home. I'll look after Ben.
Flubber-chub.
Now, Ben, would you like a nice story? Good. I'll tell you the story of my life. Once upon a time, there was a small tomato seed, and someone planted it in the ground. Oh, another day, perhaps.
How kind of you to come and ask about Ben.
I got here as fast as I could. I set out at lunchtime, but, it seems to be night already.
It's a clear night. Look!
Oh, yes, you're right, Weed. We must make a wish.
I wish that in the morning, Ben will be well.
In fact, Weed, wishes are meant to be secret. But just between you and me, that's what I wish for too.
Fertilizer.
The wishes have been answered. When Ben woke up, his nasty cold had gone.
Flubber-dub-dub!
What? Yes, you look better.
Ben! You look well again.
Flubber-dub! Rub-a-dub-a-dace.
Yes, I'm sure Bill and Tad would love a race this morning.
Flubber-dub-dub-dub!
Oh, dear.
Now Bill had a nasty cold. And it would be Ben's turn to look after Bill.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. The flower pot, Bill and Ben. The flower pot.
Oh,
It was a quiet morning in the garden, and everyone was still asleep. Everyone, that is, except Slowcoach, who seemed to have something on his mind.
Come on, shake a leg. Let's be having you. Rise and shine. Come on, wake up, you lazy lumps.
Flobbadob, it happened.
Yes. What is the matter, Slowcoach?
I'll tell you what the matter is. Look at the state of this place.
Flob.
It's no more untidy than usual.
Flob?
Flob.
That is neither here nor there, is it? My brother Lightning's coming to stay today, and I don't want him thinking I live in a dump.
You're the flubber-dubber-dubber-doo.
What do I want you to do? Tidy it up, that's what. And sharpish.
Flubber-does? You're flubber-doo.
Bill and Ben thought that if there was any tidying up to do, Slowcoach should do it. After all, it was his brother that was coming to stay.
But Slowcoach isn't as quick as you two. You'll have the garden looking spick and span in no time. Besides, it might be fun.
Flubber done!
Right then, you can make a start on your flower pots. They could do with a good tidy.
Bill and Ben hadn't realised how much stuff they had in their pots.
Oh, remember this? Oh, flubber-daddy!
Ben!
Steady on!
Flubber-dad!
What? Oh!
Flubber-dad,
Bill and Ben thought the magnifying glass was great fun.
Stop!
Slowcoach didn't.
This isn't getting the place tidy, is it? Now just put all that stuff back. I don't suppose Lightning will be spending much time in your pots. After you've done that, there's the compost heap to be dealt with, and the kettle, and the greenhouse.
Bill and Ben began to tidy the rest of the garden. They started with the compost heap.
Here, what's the big idea? Whoa!
Then they tidied the kettle.
Oh, what's happening?
The drain pipe.
Hello!
Even Thistle. At last, Bill and Ben had finished the big tidy up and went to tell Slowcoach.
Flubber-ding, flubber-up.
Not too bad, I suppose, for a couple of layabouts.
Flubber-ding, flubber-up.
Oh, when's he coming? That's a good question. Well, I sent the invitation 20 years ago, so he shall be here any minute now.
Slowcoach, my favourite brother. Good to see you.
Oh, yes. Lightning. Good to see you too. This is Bill.
The old fake hand trick. Gets him every time.
Yes. And this is Ben.
Nice to meet you too.
Slowcoach's brother Lightning thought he was very, very funny indeed.
Flubber-lub.
Bill and Ben didn't.
Flubber-lub? What's that supposed to mean?
Lightning, perhaps you'd like to meet some more of my friends.
Capital idea, particularly if they all talk daft like these two. Flobbadob.
Slowcoach took Lightning to meet Weed.
Whoa!
Or was it the other way round?
Is this your brother, Slowcoach?
Weed meet Lightning. Lightning, Weed.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Lightning, what do you think you're doing?
I always thought water was good for plants.
I'm sorry, Weed. I've forgotten Lightning was rather keen on jokes.
Lightning played tricks on everyone.
Soon have those sharp prickles filed down.
And Slowcoach tried his best to stop him.
Now that's enough, Lightning.
Ooh, morning.
Hello. Lovely day for a spot of fishing. All I need now is a nice juicy worm. I wonder where I could find one.
Lightning even played a trick on Slowcoach. He put itching powder in his shell.
Ooh!
Oh, dear. Ah, oh, it's itching. Ah.
Another one of your tricks. You. Oh, it's not funny.
It is from where I'm standing. The trouble with you, Lord, you've got no sense of humour.
By evening time, lightning had played tricks on almost everyone in the garden.
Oh, Flobbadob!
And everyone was getting pretty well fed up with him.
Right, I think a quick bath before bedtime.
It seemed that lightning liked to sing in his bath.
Stop! Stop that dreadful noise!
Sorry, Slowcoach, can't hear you. I'm singing.
Lightning kept on and on singing. No one could get any sleep, though it was long after their bedtime. And when eventually he did stop, he snored. He snored like thunder. He snored all through the night, so no one could get any sleep. Night turned to morning, and still Lightning snored.
He's got to go! He has got to go!
He's got to go, Slowcoach!
That's what I just said.
But how? How do we get rid of him?
I don't think we should do that, Bill. Certainly not.
When he was little, he used to be rather nervous of... We'd never find one big enough.
One what, Slowcoach?
A spider. A big black spider. But the only one we've got is Whimsy, and she couldn't scare the fly.
Oh, Flob had an idea.
Bill had an idea.
Flob. What? Oh, come on, Bill. This is no time for fun and games.
Flob.
I give up.
Why, you absolute... Come back here and I'll give you what for. You're going to be on the receiving end of the old lightning 1-2. No, not that. Keep it away from me. Help!
Bill said that this was only a little spider. Some of the others, said Ben, were huge. That did it. Flubber-dimsy. Weed and Slowcoach were surprised when Lightning told them that he was leaving. Bill and Ben felt rather pleased with themselves. Their plan had worked.
Bill? Ben? Lightning's gone. Flop. What did you do?
A flubble-lubble-a dazzle
head. The flubble-lubble-dim's huge.
So Bill and Ben explained why Lightning had left so quickly. But they were so tired, it wasn't long before they'd all fallen into a hard-earned sleep.
Day long, fill up.
Bill and Ben wanted to ask Weed something very important.
Flobbadobadeed?
Yes, Bill. The sun's out, so some of the buttercup flowers may have opened.
Cool! Flobbadobadob, Bill!
Why do you want to know about buttercups? Oh, I expect they'll tell me later.
Oh, yes, buttercups are special flowers.
Robert I.
Oh, no, I can't remember why they're special. Well, I mean, some days I can't even remember my own name, which is, of course...
Bill thought Slowcoach would know why buttercups are so special.
Brian?
Of course I know why buttercups are special. The famous buttercup test.
The flubber test?
The buttercup test, Bill, tells you if you like butter. Now, hold the flower under Ben's chin. Don't tickle him with it. Now, is the buttercup making Ben's chin shine yellow? Oh, flub. That means Ben does like butter. Now, you try.
Ooh, flub.
So, you both like butter. I'm not quite sure what butter is. It's something people use. It's slippy. It's slidy. And it's
yellow.
At least I think it is. Next door, Rose had a visitor.
There she is. Oh, darling Buds, isn't she beautiful?
She's all right.
Hello, hello. What's all this then?
She's a friend of the little girl who lives in our house.
What's your love? I'm Ted.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
I just said, I'm Ted.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
Oh, she soon forgets, don't she? Still, I reckon Bill and Ben would like to meet our Lulu. Hello, lads. I've got a new friend for you. This is Lulu.
Flubber Lulu.
Shake hands, then.
Oh, flubber Dill.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you? I like presents. Do you?
Bill and Ben both wanted to be Lulu's very special friend.
Friend?
I think you'll have to give Lulu a present if you want to be her special friend.
Bill had an idea.
Oh, flabadello. Dubba-dutta.
Lulu liked butter, so that was the present that Bill and Ben would give her. Bill was sure he'd find the yellow thing that people use in the shed. So that was his present.
Oh, Arben, I know of something yellow that people use. It's in that box behind you.
Oh! Flubadutta! Flub? Flub?
Lulu didn't say anything about the presents. But Bill really wanted to be her special friend, so he decided to show off.
Flubadulu!
Ben wanted to be Lulu's special friend too.
Flubadulu, you're going to
go... Ben, you've hurt your knee. Quick, rub it better.
While Ben looked after his hurt knee, Bill thought he might become Lulu's special friend if he took her away on his own.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
Oh, I'm Slowcoach.
Lulu flabberdutter slabberlub.
I expect Lulu does like butter, Bill, because I've remembered that butter is something yellow that people eat.
No?
The flower garden. Yes, I suppose you might find butter growing in the vegetable garden.
You must be hungry, Lulu.
I expect you'd like a nice lettuce leaf.
But it's not yellow, is it?
Oh, Flob. Now, Lulu, here's a delicious lettuce leaf.
Flobbadob.
Bill, you're not Lulu. Dobbaloo. No, I don't know where she's gone.
Flobbadobaloo.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
I've been worrying about that all morning. Flobbadobaloo. Lulu likes butter, does she? What is butter?
Oh, it's Flobbadob Golden Eagle.
Flobbaloo. Ben made Boo promise not to tell Bill which way he and Lulu had gone.
I won't tell Bill a thing.
Flubberabaloo!
But what thing won't I tell Bill?
Flubberlulu!
Lulu, that's it. Bill, I promised not to tell you that Ben had taken Lulu that way. So I won't.
Ah, flubberden. Oh, rubberdubberdoo.
Oh.
Ben remembered what Weed had said when he'd hurt his knee.
Rubber flubber knee! Flubber rubber better!
Hello, I'm Lulu. I like to dance.
Oh!
Flubber Lulu!
Oh, flubber
Lulu! Flubber Lulu! Flubber-ben-a-loo.
Oh, you're hiding from Bill, are you, Ben?
Flubber-ben-a-loo-loo.
Yes, I've seen Ben and Lulu. They went to the back gate.
Aha! Flubber-nizzle. Flubber.
Oh, thank you. I like a nice cuddle.
Flubber den, flubber loo!
Bill thought he and Ben must stop hiding Lulu from each other so she could decide which of them would be her very special friend.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
Bill was showing off to Lulu again.
Oi! Listen, we got trouble. The little girl who lives in our house, now she's next door in floods of tears. Can't find her friend Lulu. I've got to take her back, lads.
Flob!
Flob!
Don't be sad. Tad's right. Trying to be Lulu's special friend caused nothing but trouble between you two.
Flubber-dubber-dubber-dee.
Just forget all about her. I know. Perhaps some more buttercups have opened.
Butter! I finally remembered what butter is. It's a yellow stuff that people spread over bread. The man was eating some. Look, he's left his plate by the shed. Now you can find out if you really do like butter. Bill and Ben didn't like butter at all. Humans might eat butter, but flowerpot men don't.
So you didn't like butter after all.
Bill and Ben had found out they didn't like butter and their new friend had gone home. But they were friends again and their yellow buttercups brightened up Weed's day.
Bill and Ben, the flowerpot men. Bill and Ben, the flowerpot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben.
Thank you. It was a very quiet morning in the garden, and Slowcoach was enjoying the peace and stillness. Ah, there's nothing like a nice quiet morning's read of a good book.
Wah! Oh, it's red and carrots.
Let's get to the flubber-dubber-dive.
All right, you two. I said all right, you two. What's going on this time?
Bill and Ben explained they were playing Hunt the Carrot. One of them throws the carrot as far as he can. Then they see which of them can get to it first.
Keep it down! Oh, look at the mess they've made. Hooligans!
Ben had got to the carrot first, so now it was his turn to throw it.
Hey, you two, what about my house? Go back and...
Whimsy was having a quiet morning snooze when she was woken by a flying carrot.
What happened? It's really smelly in here.
I can flub it out of it! Flub number one!
Flub. As Ben got ready to throw the carrot again, he didn't notice that he was caught on Gnome's fishing line. Bill thought this was very funny. Ben didn't. Ben thought that Bill had something to do with it. Bill said that he hadn't. And anyway, Ben was a hopeless carrot thrower in any case.
Oh, flubber the flubber. Flubber the gonna flow.
Yeah, flubber. The flubber the gonna poo.
A flubber the gonna flubber the gonna flubber the gonna poo. So that I'm flubbering the gonna
I've got a bone to pick with you two. Have you seen the state of my house? No, of course you haven't. You've been too busy making noise and nuisance. You've got some tidy up to do, you have. Now come along and no more of your nonsense.
Bill and Ben had almost finished tidying up the mess they'd made in Slowcoach's house. But they were still cross with each other.
Come along, you two. Less of the argufying, more of the tidying, if you don't mind.
Flubber done it.
I suppose that'll do. Now I'll be off with you. And no more larking about in my house.
Bill and Ben had never been so grumpy with each other before.
Hello, you two. Finished playing your game?
Flub.
Flub.
Are you all right? You've not fallen out, have you? Oh, boys. That's enough. Oh, dear.
The garden was quiet. Very quiet indeed, and soon everyone began to wonder why.
Ah, peace at last.
Pry decided to ask Weed if she knew anything about it.
It's Bill and Ben. They've fallen out, and they're very, very grumpy.
Perhaps we'd better try to cheer them up.
Flubber.
Flub! Excuse me. Couldn't help overhearing. Bit down in the dumps, aren't we? Well, when I'm down in the dumps, I always find a game of sniff cheers me up. Do you want to play?
Flubber, flubber.
See, how you play is like this. You have a really good sniff, and the person who smells the most interesting smell is the winner. Are you ready? A one, two, three. Ah, compost. I can smell compost. How about you? Oh, not playing, eh? Well, suit yourselves. I'll just have to play on my own.
compost. Again.
Scamper arrived to see if she could cheer Bill and Ben up.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. Pry told me you were a bit down in the dumps, so... Oh, well, all the more for me.
Pry arrived with a shiny thing.
Look what I've found.
She hopes it might cheer them up. But it didn't.
Well, I like it.
Even Tad had heard about how fed up Bill and Ben were. He came along to tell them some jokes.
I'll tell you what, Bert. I went to the doctor's yesterday. I says, here, doctor, I think I'm a pair of curtains. He says, well, pull yourself together. Yeah. Right. All right, then, how about this one? I went down to the doctor's. I got a banana in one ear, a cucumber in the other, and a carrot up me nose. Doctor, I says, what's wrong with me? He says, you're not eating properly. Yeah. Right. How about this one? I says, doctor, I keep thinking I'm a dog. He says, get up on the couch then. So I says, I can't. I'm not allowed on the couch. Not allowed! You see, the doctor, because there was a dog, you see, in the couch. You can't get on there because the dog's not allowed on the couch. Oh, why?
Bill and Ben decided to go and sulk somewhere where people wouldn't try to cheer them up.
Yeah, compost.
Though Bill and Ben were both in a really bad mood, Slowcoach was feeling very happy indeed. Peace and quiet. You can't beat a bit of peace and quiet.
Oh, I don't know. Bill and Ben are really grumpy. I can't understand it.
Don't knock it, Tad. Oh, don't knock it, my boy. The longer they stay grumpy, the longer the garden will be all lovely and peaceful and quiet. Oh, lovely.
Yeah, compost.
Slowcoach was enjoying the day so much.
Oh, I'd raise my hat to you, but I haven't got a hat.
He thought he'd go for a little walk in the peaceful garden.
Coach.
Just my little joke, Weed. Just my little joke. Oh, it's nice to see those two nuisances being so quiet for...
Poor Slowcoach hadn't seen the carrot, but Bill and Ben had seen Slowcoach falling over.
What? Hey! Help! No! Oh, no! Hooligans!
Bill and Ben had almost forgotten how good it is to laugh. And how, when you're laughing, you can't stay cross with anyone for long.
Well, don't stand there giggling like a couple of hysterical hyenas. Do something.
Well, aren't you going to say thank you?
Flob?
Flobber?
To Slowcoach. After all, he's the one who cheered you up, isn't he?
Oh, my dad, Slobberlob. So they did. And they promised never to fall out with one another ever again.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
Flower pot.
One day, a marble fell into the garden.
Something fell out of the sky. Look.
I am sorry. I hope my marble didn't hit you.
We were lucky, Pry. It just missed us.
It's a bright, shiny marble, so I'm taking it to my nest. But it's so heavy and slippery it fell out of my beak. Will you put it back, please? Please catch my marble.
What was that?
Bill and Ben were pleased Whoops had stopped the marble. But Pry wasn't pleased.
Oh, just look at that marble. It's covered in mud. Not shiny at all. Whoops, you can keep it.
What is that magpie talking about?
A rubber flabble.
A marble? Looks like a grimy round thing to me. What am I supposed to do with a grimy round thing? I'm busy. I can't rush about having fun seeing the rest of the world. Oh, no. I'm stuck here hard at work. That's my life. Work.
Blobbered eyes.
And I can't dash off whenever I hear an interesting noise.
The interesting noise was coming from next door's garden.
There's Flobbadob a door.
Bill and Ben wanted to see what was making it.
Oh my goodness! What's that?
Next door, Rose was glad the noise had stopped.
Oh, my darling buds. That awful thing seems to have gone.
Didn't bother me.
I'll tell you what, Rose, it's a bit quieter, innit? That thing rushing about, it almost squashed me. I had to hide under the bridge. Oh, hello. What's this then?
The boy dropped it when he went into the house.
I wonder what this is for then.
Oh my, what's this thing buzzing around me? Is it some sort of insect? A wasp? A giant bee? My lunch? No! It's stolen my lunch!
Don't worry. Shh! And a flubber-dubber did a bump.
My seeded nuts. Into the kennel!
Warn Gnome to hide.
Flobbadob!
But Gnome was brave and wouldn't hide. So Bill and Ben hid behind him.
I've got no idea what I'm doing with this thing, you know. Don't ask me what's going on, Bill, but at least the noisy thing stopped before it crashed into us. That's just a toy the boy from our house plays with.
Flubber up.
Aha!
I think I have it. I think that toy Ben just dropped makes the horrid noisy thing race about.
Hey, maybe you're right. Hey, let's see. Yeah, Rose is right.
Oh,
you are clever, Rose. What I thought all the time.
Flobbadob lied. Yeah, well, it would be great to have a ride on it, but we're all too big.
Ben thought the one friend who was small enough to have a ride was Whoops the Worm.
He's small.
At last, he'd be able to travel round the rest of the world.
Oh, yes, I deserve a little break from my work. I expect it'll only take a few minutes to see the rest of the world. Halt! I should like to take the grimy round thing with me. After all, it's my only treasure, and I shouldn't want anyone to take it while I'm away. Thank you, Ben. Off we go! Ooh! Way! This is the life!
Seen you for ages, Whoops.
Well, you know, I don't have a lot of spare time.
Oh, you know, flubber-dubber-flubber-whoop.
Thank you, Ben. The world is most interesting. But, ooh, where does that hole lead to?
Oh, the flubber garden.
Next door's garden? You mean there's another garden in the world? Ooh, I should like to see the world's other garden.
Flubberdill.
Hey, Bill, be careful. He's heading straight for the pond.
Ah!
Ooh! My grimy round thing, my treasure, it's in the water. Don't worry, I can reach it. Well done, Tad. Oh? It's not grimy anymore.
I say, I think I saw something shiny.
Well, I've no time for marbles. Pry, you can have it back. I've got work to do. Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Ben. And thank you, Tad. I have had a splendid time.
That's
no problem. I shall slither back to work and think how proud I am to have seen the rest of the world. Goodbye.
Flubber-dubber-dubber.
See you later.
Well done, everybody. You must take that noisy thing back to your garden. The boy may want to play with it.
Yeah, you're right, Weed. I'll have that, thanks. See you later.
Cheer up. You've had a very exciting day, but who knows what tomorrow may bring.
Bill and Ben knew Weed was right. They couldn't wait to get to sleep so they could wake up and have another adventure.
Bill